Bella Gabbers, welcome in this new video. Today I'm gonna show you 5 tricks you should know if you are an ardent music producer. Let's start from the first one. If you want that your melody sounds big, you have to layer different sounds in different octaves. Let's use this melody as example. In this way sounds a little bit too basic, but let's duplicate this layer moving down the melody of one octave. And this is the result. In this way, it's way better. But let's also change the preset of the second layer. And using this kind of mindset for all the melody, we get something like this. Very, very nice. Let's move to the second trick, the pogo nub. Here we have two different kicks, one gated kick and one tonal kick. If you open the sampler of the kick, simply clicking double times on the kick with the left click of the mouse, we can find in this section the pogo nub. The pogo nub is a particular effect that pitch your kick in a particular way. It's very very cool, use it directly into the punch of the kick. But if the tail of your kick doesn't have a specific note, you can also use this effect also on the entire kick. Ah, and if you don't have FL Studio and you don't have the pogo nub, this is the solution. It's called Nimble Kick and it has the pogo nub. Let's move to the third trick. If you want to make a hardcore mainstream snare like this, the first thing we have to do is pitch our snare of 12 semitones, or rather one octave. And the second thing we have to do is choose the right snare. Because if I do the same thing with a wrong snare, we don't get an effect like this. We have to choose a snare with a very accentuated resonance. For example, a dubstep snare like this. And for example, this is a wrong snare if you want to get a sound like that. Then, if we want to add the reverse effect, we have to simply duplicate the sound and select reverse in the sampler. Now let's move to the fourth trick, or rather the reverberated kick. This is the kick without the reverb. And this is the kick with the reverb. To get this effect, I simply connected the channel of the kick into another channel that I called reverb. Then I inserted an equalizer with two bands, one to cut the lows and one to cut the highs, because we don't want these type of frequencies in the reverb, otherwise it will sound unnatural. Then I inserted the reverb using the preset cathedral, but setting the dry to the minimum and the wet to the max. Then again we have another equalizer, the same equalizer as before, because the reverb can generate frequencies that we don't want. And this is the final result. But before to start to explain the tricks, I want to say you one thing. I recently published my new track, Tunnel Vision. It's out on Rude Vibes. If you want to listen it, I leave you the link in the description. Now let's move to the fifth trick. If we have FL Studio and we open the sampler, we can find the Stretch Pro mode. This is without the stretch mode, this is the classic mode of time stretching. This is the Stretch Pro. But the really cool thing is this knob, the formant knob. That combined with the pitch knob can completely change your kicks. With these two knobs you have only to free your fantasy. And if you want to know more about hard dance music production, remember that I have a Patreon with a lot of detailed tutorials. With the cost of just 2 euros you have the access to a lot of videos. And this is all for today, see you next time in a new video. Bella Gabbers!